Hi guys, this is my C programming interview question and answer video. In this video, we are going to continue with our next 20 questions. This video contains lot of questions that are asked in the GATE exam question paper. Let's move on to the first question. What is the output of the following program? Hash include std abort attach void main open curly int array a equal to 100, 200, 300. Print the second element of the array. Here you have to note one thing, that the subscript, that is the square bracket, is placed before the variable name, which is invalid in C. So the result of the code is going to be compilation error. The valid declaration of an array is, see this explanation part, int a of a, after that only square bracket, that only is the correct declaration of the array. So it is a compilation error. Moving on to the next question. What is the output of the following program if the array address starts with 1000? Let's read the code now. Hash include std abort attach void main open curly int array equal to 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Okay, now we are asked to print the address of the array. Array means we are mentioning the address of the first array element that we have in the question itself, that is 1000. So for this one, the answer is going to be 1000. Next, moving to the next one, array plus 1, that means the 20th element. They are asking the address for the 20th element. To calculate the address of the 20th element, we have to add the address of the 0th element plus the size of the integer. By default, it is long int, so 4 byte. So 1000 plus 4, it is going to be 1004, that is going to be the address of the first element. And now we are asked to print the address of the next array. To get the address of the next array, the step is going to be 1000 plus size of the int into 5, which is going to be 1020, that is going to be the address of the next array element. That is the base address plus how many elements? 5 elements, and their size is 4. That we have to multiply and add it with the 0th element address, so that will give the address of the next array element, that is 1020. So answer is option A. Moving on to the next question. What is the output of the following program? Hash include stdio.h void main open curly char c is equals to gate 2011. So character array gate 2011, char star p is equals to c. So we are giving the address of the string to the pointer variable, and now we are going to print the string by performing some arithmetic operations on the string. So what will be printed after performing this operation, that is what we are going to deduce. Let's see it. So p of 3 means they are pointing to the 0 1 2 3, e. P of 3 points to e. P of 1 means that is pointing to a. P means that is pointing to g. Okay, so now let's perform the subtraction first. P of 3 minus p of 1, that is, we are going to subtract the ASCII value of E and A. See this explanation part. ASCII value of E is going to be 69. ASCII value of capital A is going to be 65. So if you subtract this both, we are getting 4. So that 4 is going to be added with the P. So P plus 4, which can be written as P of 4. P of 4 means that is pointing to 2. That is this one. P of 4 means it is pointing to 2. So the after this entire string will be printed, the result is going to be 2011. Option C is our answer. So to perform arithmetic operation in pointers, we are using the ASCII values and subtracting them, and what is going to be the result. Based on the result, we are going to print the entire string based on it. So answer is C. Moving on to the next question. Below program compiled successfully or not, that is our question. Hash include std abort attach int main open curly. Here we have having the structure declaration and definition. Structure student open curly int id char name of 20 close curly. Structure student a, outside of the structure they are giving the variable for the structure. A dot id is equals to 20 and close curly. And one thing you have to note that is structure has been missing and semicolon. Once the structure ended, it should have a semicolon, that is our syntax. Since it is missing, it is not going to compile successfully. The result is going to be B, false, because semicolon is missing here. Moving on to the next question. What function can be used to allocate new memory in C? Now we are coming to the memory allocation concept in C, which we have learnt in our C tutorial video. So for memory allocation in C, we are using, as we have learnt, malloc, realloc, calloc are used for the memory allocation in C. Moving on to the 47th question, what function should be used to free the memory that has been allocated by malloc or calloc? The function that is used to free the memory is free function. That is the answer. 48th question, which header file should be included in a C program to use malloc, calloc, realloc and free? So for including all these in our code, we have to use standard lib.h. This header file has to be included to use all these functions in our code. Moving on to the next question, malloc returns an int pointer if the memory allocated for storing integer and double pointer if memory is allocated for storing double. No, it's false, because we have already learned that malloc or calloc, anything that will return only a void pointer. So B is our answer, that is false. Moving on to the 50th question, the pointer returned by calloc and malloc are successful memory allocation as void pointer. Yeah, that is true. Moving on to the next question, are the types of x and y in the following program are same? Let's see that. Type definition int myint, int x, myint y. So type definition means, we have learned this concept. What does mean by type definition? Type definition that will give new name for the existing data type. So here we have declared myint as a type definition. So this can be used as an integer data type for declaring another new variable, that is y. So the answer is going to be yes. Both means the same data type only. By means of type definition, we are giving new name for the existing data type. So the answer is A, yes. Moving on to the 52nd question, what is the output of the following program? Hash include yesterday ordered h int main open curly enum color red comma green comma blue. Type definition enum color my color. My color m is equals to blue. So print of m. We know the type definition concept, that is giving the new name for the existing data type. And enum concept, that is used for creating our own data type and give some values to the data type. So in this code, what we are doing is that we are creating our own data type and giving the values with the help of type definition and enum. So enum will give values starting from 0 by default. So red is going to be having 0, green is going to carry the value 1, and blue is going to be allocated with the value 2. Since we are printing the value of m, that is blue, the answer is going to be C2. Moving on to the next question, 53rd question, prototype of printf or scanf function are present in which header file? stdio.h, standard input output header file that only contains printf and scanf, that is used for inputting and outputting in our C program. Moving to the 54th question, file is a structure that is defined in stdio.h, hence for using the structure including stdio.h is must. Yeah, it's true. It is true that we have to include stdio.h for using the structure in our file structure in our code. 55th question, what is the output of the following program? Hash include stdio.h, hash include string.h, int main, open curly, character array has been declared here. So file star fptr, fp is equal to, so file pointer is declared here, and using the file pointer we are opening the file and we are copying some file file text into the str, that is into the str. So we are opening the file in the write mode, and then we are closing the file and ending the program. So this program will work fine and no error will be displayed. I will explain this in the explanation part. See here, fp has been declared as a pointer to the structure. called file, which has been defined with the, in the header file stdio.h. We know this one. So for accessing any file, we must open the file in a proper method. So file, as we have said, the file has been opened and the text has been copied by opening it in the right mode, and file is closed. No error in this program. It is the everything is done as per the procedure. So it is going to be no error and it works fine. We have to declare the file pointer, that has been done. Then we have to open the file in some mode and we are going to copy the text and we are going to close the program. It works well fine. Means because it is syntactically correct. Okay, moving on to the next code, 56th code. In the following program, what is the meaning of argc and argv? The code is hash include stdio.h int main. So main, we have learned this concept. This is command line argument concept. So we, as we have learned, the main main function of the code will have two parameters, that is argc and argv. So the meaning of argc, argc means count of the arguments, argv means vector of the arguments. So A and D is our answer. 57th question, a bit can have only one of the two values, 0 or 1. Yes, it is true. A bit means it can have a 0 value or 1 value. 58th question, which bitwise operator is suitable for turning off a particular bit of number? For making off and on operation, the best operator for using that is AND operator. Option D is the answer. 59th question, which bitwise operator is suitable for turning on a particular bit of number? To make turn on, OR operator is the best operator for making the turning on. Which bitwise operator is suitable for checking whether the particular bit is on or off? On or off means AND operator by default is used for checking whether the bit is on or off. 61st question, what is the binary equivalent of 0x? 0x means hexadecimal. So this is going to be hexadecimal number 1, 2, 3, 4. So we are going to find the binary equivalent. Binary equivalent means, see this explanation part, we are going to use 8421 method for expanding it. Okay. So 0x, you have to leave that one. This indicates, this is just an indication to make the user know that it is an hexadecimal number. We have to expand from 1 to 4. So first for 1. 8421 method. So you have to write 8421. 1 means you have to put 1 in the at that corresponding place. So 001 is the binary form of 1. For 2 means 8421 again. So in the second place you put 1 means the 2 is included in our 2 is included. So 0010. Another and for the next one is 3. 3 means 2 and 1 is going to be made 1 and 1 to get the 3 value. So 0011 is for the binary equivalent for 3. And 4 means 84. In the third place you are going to put 1 to get the 4 binary equivalent. So 0100. So if this is the binary equivalent for 1, 2, 3, 4. Answer is option B. 8421 method you have to use for expanding each and every decimal numbers. Moving on to the 62nd question, what is the output of the following program? Hash include stdio.h int main, int I equal to 64, j is equals to hexadecimal 40, k comma l comma m. So we are going to perform some operations here, and we are going to print the values of each and every numbers. So we will see that 64 for I is 64. So for performing AND, OR and XOR operation, we have to first convert the numbers into the binary numbers. So for 64, the binary equivalent is 100000, and for 40, which is an hexadecimal of the decimal number 64, if you convert them into the binary, that is going to be the same numbers, that is 100000. Now first is OR operation. OR operation, we know that if anything is 1, any bit is 1, the resulting bit is also going to be 1. So here the first position 1 and second first here also first position 1. So it is going to be 1000, that is the 64 is going to be the answer for K. And L is equals to I and J. I AND J means we are asked to perform the AND operation. AND means if both the bits are 1, the resulting bit is going to be 1. So here is 1, here is 1, the resulting bit is 1. Remaining all 0, remaining all 0. So AND operation returns remaining all 0. And the decimal equivalent for this is 64. Next we are asked to perform the XOR K. K XOR J. XOR means the bits are going to be alternate values. Bits are going to hold alternate value only. It is going to give the result as 1. If the bits are having the same value, that is 1 and 1, means it is going to be 0. 0 and 0 means it is going to be 0. So everything is 0. So the decimal equivalent for that is 0. So the value of I is 64. The value of J is 64. Since we are asked to print the decimal equivalent, so 640 is the 0x40, the decimal equivalent for that is 64, and K we have derived it 64, L 64, and M is 0. So the answer is option C. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video. That is the end of the video. Please watch the next video to learn new 20 questions. Thank you guys, like and subscribe.